So first, I want to thank everyone for coming out. Many of you may have been at the parade. I recognize some of you. Some of you were at the reflagging on Saturday. Thank you again for that. I want to thank some of our special guests here. Representative Phillips, Select Boardman, VFW, AmVets, and there's some Legion here. Hey, Mike. I think we should take a moment for a moment of silence.
Detail on cover. Detail, cover.
So this is my first Veteran Memorial Square dedication, and I got the privilege to learn so much about Charlie. I'm gonna get a little bit closer. I got the opportunity to learn a lot about this veteran, and I learned he's one of those guys that shows up. He came to almost every event, if not every event. And as we know, just showing up sometimes is a trait we very rarely see in a person. He was a veteran. He seemed to internalize that service before self. And that's something a lot of us vets, you know, don't always hold on to also. And when someone does, even if they are a veteran, it's great to see. I've had an opportunity to talk to Millie. I've got to read the letters some of you wrote for him. I've talked to regular people. You say that name and they know him. Oh, he was here. He said this. Just a little while ago, I learned he had a saying. All gave some gave all. Now, that means some people might hear that and think it's just a turn of phrase. But for those of us who have lost our friends while we were serving, or after, it really means something to me personally. So when I heard that, it just added to his for me, mythology. I never got to meet him, unfortunately, but God, I wish we had 100 of them in town. So now I'll turn it over. We're going to read some proclamations, some citations, and I think I'll turn this over now.
Can they hear you over there?
That's just going to the
microphone. Yeah, that's for this TV.
I'll go over here. Hawaii, everybody. I think most of you know who I am, Scotty Carrara. I've known Charlie probably all my life. And I always thought he had one of the coolest Fords. I'm a Ford man, he had a nice Ford truck. So from the town of Stoughton, proclamation. Whereas Charles L. Wade was born on January 17th, 1930. And whereas Charles enlisted in the United States Army on September 20th, 1951, attaining the rank of corporal and was honorably discharged on August 31st, 1953. And whereas Charles has been a member of the VFW Post 1645 for over 40 years. During all these years, he has volunteered for almost all events. And whereas Charles devoted himself to serving the community, and he was an active member in the Color Guard and served on many different boards and committees for our town for decades. And whereas Charles passed away on August 7th, 2020, at the age of 90. Now, therefore, we, Deborah Roberts, Stephen M. Cavey, Scott Carrara, Joseph M. McChrisky, and Lou Gito, members of the Stoughton Board of Selectmen, in recognition of his contributions to his country and his town, do hereby designate the corner of Prospect Street and Broadway, Charles L. Wade Jr. Square. This proclamation was made the 30th day of May in the year of our Lord, 2022. And it'll be signed by the chairman of the board, Deborah Roberts. toss this off to senior member Mr. McCrisky.
I don't think I need this.
I don't need it.
You need it.
People who know me, I'm a loud mouth anyway, right?
Turn the volume up.
You need it for smack.
For smack? Okay. Okay, for smack, we need it. Okay. My pleasure to be here. And I was just saying, when I spent some time with Joe DeVito earlier, you know, at the Memorial Day Parade, helping him move around a little bit. And we were just talking about how, you know, a lot of our World War II guys are no longer here. And my generation, Scots, when we ran for office, you always had to check in. You had to make sure you had the blessing of certain people. Charlie was one. And I asked him, what do I need to do a good job? He says, don't talk, right? I'll never forget that. Now, for me, that's pretty difficult. But we also shared the love when I got the old Maxim fire truck back, engine 2, and he had shared some stories with it. And he wasn't one the only ones that said that truck was a piece of crap then. It's probably still a piece of crap. And I don't know if it was cursed, but it broke down a lot. Let's just say that. But we had some fun, and my generation is Charlie's one of the guys that I looked up to. He was great friends with my father-in-law Joe Silva, and they shared a lot of the war stories. But you know, this generation, you respect people like that. And unfortunately, the older I get now, these generations are gone on now. It's sad. We've got Joe with us, and you know, when you had all these people there over the years at the 4th of July parade and, you know, Memorial Day and Veterans Day, there was somebody you could relate to. And the way the world's turning now, that we kind of lose that, you know, and it was always our veterans that could pull us together because they earned it. They were the ones that put their lives on the line, you know, to celebrate the freedom that, you know, and unfortunately, in some times today, people take for granted. We wake up, we go about our business, and we just don't, you know, we don't respect it. But I'm honored to be here and to remember Charlie. He was a great Stoughton guy, a great Stoughton servant in more than one way, but I looked at him as a great friend, somebody I could look up to. So it's the board's honor to be able to have this happen for Charlie. He definitely earned it. Thank you.
Nice to see you too, Joe.
All right. I'll bring this up here since this is for SMAC. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is State Representative Ted Phillips. It's a privilege to be here with you all. I want to start by thanking Charlie for this unbelievable weather. We have dedicated squares in the past in the cold and the rain, and I'll take this any day. So thank you, Charlie, wherever you are. It is a privilege for me to be here representing Stoughton's legislative delegation. Unfortunately, Representative Galvin could not be here with us today, and Senator Timulty, because he has 10 towns in his district, is over participating in Easton's Memorial Day celebrations right now. But he graciously sent his aide, Kathy, who's with us and who brought a citation from the Massachusetts Senate, and I have one from the House. And they read very much the same, which is to say that, be it hereby known to all, that the House and the Senate offer their sincerest congratulations to the Wade family. In recognition of the intersection of Prospect Street and Broadway in the town of Stoughton being named the Corporal Charles L. Wade Jr. Memorial Square. The entire membership extends its very best wishes and expresses the hope for future good fortunes and continued success in all endeavors, given this 30th day of May 2022 at the State House of Boston, Massachusetts. The Senate citation is signed by Senate President Karen E. Spilka, Clerk of the Senate Michael D. Hurley, and State Senator Walter F. Timulty. The House of Representatives citation, which I'm slightly losing here, is signed by Speaker of the House Ron Mariano, State Representative William C. Galvin, and myself, a very grateful State Representative Edward R. Phillips. Congratulations.
I need three people from the family to help unveil the sign and place the flag into sprigs. You're gonna have to climb up a ladder, so it might be a little difficult.
There's two. One more,
no? I need one more.
Just three. Three. They're all three. It's okay.
Thank you.
I'm gonna pull this and I want you to pull down that. I'm gonna pull down, Mike. We're ready to go.
They, Do they like pop? Like fancy clotheslines. Oh, don't lose that. Look at that sign. Yes, I can. Thank you. Next volunteer, please. Can we get? Oh, okay. We're gonna need one more after this. Oh no, I think. There we go. Thank you. Good job. There's one on the...
Give me a second.
Yeah, take your time.
No, we don't know if that's really any help.
Prepare to honor.
Prepare to
honor the dead. Detail, hut, ten, hut! Precinct, house,
half right, face.
Ready.
I just want to again thank everyone for coming out and in support, and how everyone came around for Charles, and all of your work on applying, and all of his dedication to this town has led up to this physical memorial for him at the corner of Prospect and Broadway. This will be here for many, many years. And if anyone in the family has any words they might want to share, please let me know. Oh, it's okay. Here, I can bring this right to you.
Okay. I think everybody can hear this gravelly voice.
That's what you should sound like, Sean, right there.
I want to thank everybody that had anything to do with dedicating this square to Charlie. And it started with him, because he told his son and me before he passed that this is what he wanted done. He wanted it put up by the house he grew up in. His parents built this house. And he was 5 years old when he moved in there. And he stayed there until we married. Then later years, we bought a house over there so that he could take care of his mother. So this is a great neighborhood. And it was with mixed emotions that we left. But I like where I am. So I especially want to thank the veterans agents for all the help that they have been to Charlie and I and all the other widows and veterans in town. And to this honor guard that comes out all the time for parades and dedications, they're tireless in what they do. Charlie joined both the American Legion and the VFW in 1954, and he was active every year. Too many things to try to cover, so I just want to thank everyone for all of their help and for showing up here today, being friends, and also to invite you for light refreshments back at my community room at 11 Roosevelt Circle in Southeastern. Go right in beside Stone Forge Grill and follow the sign to number 11. And I look forward to seeing you there. Thank you again.
Oh, okay. Cheers.
Thank you for that. I just want to say thank you first. That was really great. Such kind words. I hope when all of us are gone, we have someone that remembers us in that way. And this will conclude the dedication ceremony. Again, I want to thank everyone who came out. Everyone again. Everyone who came out, the AMVETS, the Legion, the VFWs. The select board, the police, fire, Norfolk County, everyone. I've said this so many times, I don't know why I'm stumbling today. Always know that if there is a VSO agent in town, and I will do whatever I can to help you with applications or anything you have if you're a veteran in town, okay? Again, thank you for coming out.
Congratulations.